Welcome to Covidence's step-by-step guide to setting up a data extraction template. In this video, we will walk you through the essential steps for setting up and using a data extraction template using Covidence's Extraction 1 tool. Extraction 1 tool is ideal for reviews evaluating the effectiveness of drugs, therapies, devices, or policies. You can also use this tool if you are evaluating exposures or other phenomena of interest. Data extraction involves gathering and organizing data from studies to facilitate analysis or the creation of a narrative summary. Using a template is crucial in developing information in a standardized manner, reducing the need to repeatedly reference original sources. Covidence assists in creating a well-structured data extraction template, and building a good data extraction form requires 5 key steps. First, decide on the data you would like to capture, and this is typically at the review protocol stage. Develop a clear and user-friendly structured template. Third, extract the data and implement any additional modifications. Four, compare the data and reach consensus before exporting the final data for analysis and synthesis. Let's look at the data extraction template using a real review as an example. This review used the PICO framework, which is commonly used in interventions reviews. PICO stands for population, intervention, comparison, and outcome. If you are conducting a review which looks at exposures or other phenomena of interest, you can add these into the intervention section. For this example, a data extraction template is based on a review assessing the effectiveness of subcutaneous defibrillators versus transvenous defibrillators in patients at risk of sudden cardiac death. My population are adults 18 years or older in randomized controlled trials. My intervention is the use of subcutaneous defibrillators compared to the traditional transvenous defibrillator. Outcomes are the measures used to assess the effectiveness of the treatment. The outcomes are the sudden cardiac death and all-cause mortality, as well as some adverse events like inappropriate shocks, device infections, and lead-related complications. To create the data extraction template, go to the extraction section on the review summary screen. Then click on Create a Data Extraction Template button. Initially, this button is blue, but it turns white once the template is published. Data extraction cannot begin until the template is created and published. The template can be customized to suit the specific needs of the review. After making changes, click on the Publish Template button to save and apply it to all the studies in the review. There are 5 key sections in the template: identification, methods, population, intervention, and outcomes. I will go through each section one by one for the example review. The identification section of the template is used to capture general information about the studies, such as their setting, funding sources, and authors' contact information. There's also an additional data section where custom fields can be added, such as the trial, start, and end dates, and such as the study centers, and trial registry number or the study registry number, and I added these as an example. In the study form, you'll have the ability to view and fill out the fields such as the study details, sponsorship source, country and settings, as well as the author's contact details, along with any additional data as well. Covidence now provides automatic extraction suggestions in Extraction 1 identification section for fields where reliable values can be sourced, provided that a DOI is available. These suggestions are enabled by default. Extraction suggestions will show for all users, requiring them to either accept or reject each suggestion individually through the tick and cross actions. Next is the methods section of the template, and it is designed to capture key details on the study aims, objectives, recruitment, or blinding. There are 2 subheadings. The method details subheading contains 2 default non-removable fields, and there's the additional data subheading, which allows for adding custom fields specific to the review. An example includes study aim, objective, or method of recruitment. I've added this as an example, and I will add also other as well. Having another option is useful to capture any additional information. And if you click on the tooltip of each section, you can find a link to the knowledge base article with example fields that might be useful for your review. Now, in the study form, you'll be able to see the design, the first non-removable field, and you'll see the drop-down menu of different study designs, as well as the different options for groups, and the additional methods data subheading, along with the method of recruitment field and other as well. Next is the population section of the template. Here you can capture details about study participants, including eligibility criteria and group differences. So the first subheading is the population details subheading, where it contains three default fields and they are non-removable. The inclusion and exclusion criteria, you can record the eligibility criteria from your protocol, as well as the group differences, which notes any significant differences between the intervention groups, such as age or severity. Next is the baseline characteristics subheading. Here does not include any default fields, but allows for the addition of custom fields, such as mean age, percentage of male, BMI, and renal function. These were added all as an example from my review. Their characteristics appear as a table during data extraction with columns for each intervention group and the overall population. Next, under additional data subheading, here you can also add custom fields specific to the review, such as the total sample size, number of withdrawals or dropouts, or the reason for withdrawals. Again, I added another option as well here, so I can record in case I have any additional data, I'd like that recorded as well. In the study form, you'll be able to add here the inclusion and exclusion criteria, details, as well as any group differences. And then you're able to record any information regarding the total sample size or number of withdrawals and so on, as well as the table with the characteristics and then the overall as well population. As you can see, the moment you select one or two of these interventions, then you'll be able, similar to this one, then you'll be able to record the characteristics for each intervention group, as you can see here. Next is the intervention section. This section captures details about the interventions and comparisons received by each group. Under the intervention characteristics subheading, custom fields can be added to record details such as the intervention's definition, dose, frequency, or delivery method. These characteristics appear as a table during data extraction with columns for each user-defined intervention group. In this example, I will add my intervention, my subcutaneous defibrillator, and comparison or control is my transvenous defibrillator, with characteristics such as the number of participants allocated, and also I added other as well as an additional field. If you are conducting a review which looks at exposures or other phenomena of interest, you can add this here under the intervention section. Now, here in the study form, when extracting data from a study, you can then select which interventions or comparisons were included and also add multiple groups which were given to this intervention or comparator. So in this case, for example, I have first group new design subcutaneous defibrillator and an old design for subcutaneous defibrillator. The outcome section of the template is designed to capture numerical data for key outcomes and information on how each outcome was defined and measured. When adding an outcome to the template, three required fields must be completed. The first is the name of the outcome. In my case, is all-cause mortality is my first outcome of interest. And you need to select then the type of the outcome, whether it's continuous or dichotomous outcome. In my case, it's dichotomous, so I'll click on dichotomous. Third, you need to select the time points of interest, such as baseline, end of study, or specific durations. In this case, I've selected 12-month and 24-month as my time points. I can add the second outcome of interest, which is the sudden cardiac death, and I'll be also reporting this as a dichotomous outcome, as well as I will select 12-month and 24-month as my time points. Finally, is the results section of the template, which highlights what result data can be captured for each outcome. For continuous measures, for example, the available options will include the mean, standard deviation, and sample size, with a choice of adding whether a standard error or 95% confidence interval. For my dichotomous measures, you can select the number of events or percentage along with the total sample size, and there are additional options to report effect estimates for both continuous and dichotomous measures, such as the mean difference for continuous measures, and for dichotomous measures it could be hazard ratio, odds ratio, or relative risk. You can also have the option to add custom measures when extracting your data. A table is automatically created for entering results data for each outcome during data extraction. So in a study form, when extracting data from a study, you can then, in the outcomes section, select which outcomes and time points were included. So in this case, I will also click on sudden cardiac death because this paper reported on both my all-cause mortality and sudden cardiac death outcomes. Then you can also add any reported name for your outcome. It could be, in this case, death from any cause, as well as you can also add an optional reported time. Instead of 12 months, it could be 1 year or 2 years. And next is the results section of the extraction form. Here you can see a results table will be created for each outcome. And here you can extract the numerical results data. And if other data is reported, you can also edit the table and create custom measures. So you can click on edit and always change and create a new custom measure if needed. And you can also change from an arm level data to an effect estimate as well from here. And that's it. Once the template is finalized, you can click on Publish Template button. This will allow you to start data extraction. And at any time during data extraction, you can update the template and all changes will be applied to all studies. For more information and practical tips and advice, download a free copy of our tool for focus on intervention systematic reviews ebook from the resources section of the Covidence website. You can get more support by emailing support@covidence.org at any time or by visiting our Covidence.org website or via our knowledge base.